God bless you, family. How are you guys today? Good morning, good morning, good morning. It's Motivational Monday. I hope you guys are all feeling good. I hope you guys had an amazing, amazing, amazing weekend. I'm gonna start praying, amen, and just setting the atmosphere, amen, for all of the ladies and gentlemen and all the family who's going to be coming in this morning, amen. Heavenly Father, we welcome you this morning. We give you all the glory, all the honor, Father God. We give you all the praise, Father God. We thank you for what you're doing in our life, Father God. We thank you for the bad moments. We thank you for the good moments. We just thank you, Holy Spirit. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Abba, Father. We just thank you because you're working things together for our good. I don't know how you guys are feeling this morning, but I want you guys to trust in the Lord this morning. I want you guys to have an expectation in your heart this morning. I want you guys to be connected to the vine in a mighty and powerful way. I want you guys to be stomping on the enemy this morning. I want you guys to be full of love. I want you guys to be full of hope. I want you guys to be bold in your faith. I want you guys to just wreck the gates of hell this morning in such a mighty, mighty, mighty way in the mighty name of Jesus, because the plans that God has for your life are bigger. The plans that he has for my life, our life, are bigger than the plans that we got for ourselves. So we got to trust and believe that God is with us. We got to trust and believe this morning that God is leading us, and we got to trust and believe that he's gonna have his way. God bless you, Linda. God bless you, hermana. I love you. I bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. If you guys could definitely hit that share button. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna make sure that I also share. Amen. Let me share the broadcast on my page, because I did not get to do the restream this morning, like, and do it on all the other platforms. But I am gonna go really quickly before I share this powerful word with you guys. I'm just gonna definitely just share it on my church page. Share to page. Let me share it on my private page, my other public page, and then let me share it on the church one. Amen. Share to page, and then we can definitely get started. Okay, today's word is definitely going to minister to your life. If the enemy has been just messing with you, if he's just been making you feel like, you know what, you're not gonna amount to nothing, we shut the enemy up today in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. If you got to tell the enemy shut up today, be filled with boldness, be filled with power, be filled with anointing to tell the enemy to just shut up in the mighty name of Jesus, okay? So today's topic is going to be crossing over, okay? Now, what I'm doing today is something that I'm gonna continue doing in my membership, okay? My private group that's called Destroying Evil Altars. Really soon, I'm gonna be doing a lot of texting every day, short verses. I already do it with a majority of the girls, but in the membership, it's gonna be daily videos in the morning. We're gonna have like our morning devotional like this, and daily text, you know, is motivation, talking to the girls, you know, throughout the week, putting them in a on the chat, on, you know, where we could just connect with each other, because that's what it's all about. It's all about us connecting with each other. It's all about us moving forward. It's all about just doing what God called us to do and not letting the enemy hinder us in our journey, because God has too many plans for our life. You know, for some people, you know, they may not see how important it is to have someone motivating you every day, but let me tell you something, the struggle is real, okay? So we always need someone in our corner motivating us and reminding us what the plan of God is and what his will is for our life. There are so many people, right, Isela, that they will not, okay, gear you towards God's plans. They will not gear you, you know, towards the purpose that God has for your life. This is why it is so important and to be connected to powerful people in the kingdom of God that are going to help you, that are going to motivate you, that are going to encourage you and lift you up, okay, and lift up the name of Jesus Christ higher than their own, and that is going to gear you to a place of victory, a place of overcoming, a place where you can start blessing those that are around you and start bearing that good fruit. God bless you, Maria. Amen, Marie. God bless bless you, hermana. Amen. You know, that's what it's all about. It's all about us bearing fruit for the Lord, for the kingdom, encouraging each other. Amen. So today's word, right, that we're going to be talking about is crossing over. Okay, so it says, whoever hears my words and believes in him who sent me has eternal life. Okay, so you see what God is saying to us? He's saying, whoever hears my words and believes, okay, in him who sent me has eternal life. We have to believe in the Bible. We have to believe in the word of God. There are so many people out there that are going to try to discourage you. There are family, because in the moment when you're crossing over, when you're going from death to life, okay, there are so many people that are going to be discouraging you. So God wants to remind you today. He wants to remind you on this powerful morning, whether you're watching the broadcast live, whether you're going to watch the replay later today, whenever I upload it to YouTube, whenever it is that you get to hear this video, God wants you to understand and to know that there is nothing more powerful than his word, okay? And believing in the one who sent the word, believing in the, because the Bible says in the beginning was the word and the word was God. So the word of God came from the kingdom of heaven. It came from the Father himself, amen? So we cannot allow our lives as human beings, we have to stay motivated. We got to stay encouraged. We have to follow the righteous path that the Father and Jesus himself and the Holy Spirit has laid out before us as his children. As Christians, we believe in the word. We believe in Jesus. We believe in the Father. Why? Because there's no other hope in our life. No other hope can come through. Yes, it's a beautiful experience when you got family members around you. It's a beautiful experience when you got your kids or you able to accomplish certain milestones in your life. Yes, that's a really good thing. But you got to have the main source of your joy, the main source that keeps you fueling and moving forward. It has to be the Father. It has to be Jesus. It has to be the Word. If you cannot connect to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit and the Word of God, if that is not your source and it's not working out for you, I encourage you to try it. Try Jesus. Try the Holy Spirit. Try the Father. Try the Word of God and see, allow the Holy Spirit to just transform your life. Because when you're trying to cross over from darkness into the light, there are so many things that are going to try to hinder you. So he says, whoever hears my word and believes in him who sent me, okay, has eternal life. Your life is eternal. You may want to have a good life, a great life with no suffering, with no drama here on the earth, without evil following you every 5 minutes. Can I get an amen? Because there is always going to be something that is going to make you feel uncomfortable around the corner. You may feel good for a season. You may feel good for a little bit. But guess what? The new levels, it brings new devils. So when you're able to accomplish a new milestone in your life, such as crossing over, you're not going to have people that are going to be sitting there. God bless you, hermana Ulbay. You're not going to have people that are going to be sitting there in your corner, like rooting you on and checking on you every week and making sure you know that you're moving forward. That's why I love being connected to the mentorship. I love being connected to the women of God. And if you need encouragement and you don't have it, send me your name, send me your email, send me your cell phone number, and I'll gladly add you to the list, and I will keep you accountable, because it's so important to be held accountable in this walk. Because I tell, you know, the women of God all the time, don't let nobody pick on you. Don't let nobody point no fingers at you. You know, that's what God called me to do. Why? Because I'm so vigilant, right, hermana Glenda? I'm so vigilant when it comes to these wolves out here trying to tear you apart. You a woman of God. You know how hard it is in the kingdom of God? Let me put this down for a minute, okay? You know how hard it is in the kingdom of God, right? You got to deal not only with yourself. You got to deal with your past. You got to deal with your insecurities, the things that you brought to the table before and after Christ. You got to deal with yourself. So in this journey, when you're crossing over, you got to deal with a lot of the things that were in your past that were, you got to deal with situations that really weren't dealt with. So God, as you're crossing over, He comes to clean the atmosphere. He comes to clean the heart. He comes to clean everything. God bless you, Miss Trina. God bless you, Bia. God bless you, sisters. God bless you. Welcome, welcome, welcome. If you guys could just hit that share button, I would appreciate it so much. Amen. So, you know, when you come into the kingdom of God, you gotta like detoxify everything that you've been going through, you know? And a lot of people, they may not be able to see your suffering. Your family members and the people that you got close to you, they may not be able to see the scars that you have in your heart. Okay? They may not be able to see that, but guess what? God sees that. Amen. The Hermana Road, Glenda Road, last night someone started telling me that the Bible is fake. I had to rebuke it. Yes, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Let me see what else. You know why? Because when we are, like, let me tell you something. Even when we baptize people, and I told them when we baptized everybody last week, right? The main thing that I said was don't let nobody pick on you guys. Don't let nobody point no fingers and be like, but ain't you baptized? Why? Because when you guys all decided to say, I love Jesus, I want to follow Jesus, it doesn't mean that you're going to stop drinking overnight. It doesn't mean you're going to stop smoking overnight. It doesn't mean you're going to stop cursing overnight. It doesn't mean you're going to dress different and all of a sudden you're going to look like a pastor, like, whew, like tomorrow, like, you know, like them TikTok videos, you look one way and then in the snap of a finger, you look like another way. People think in their mind that that's the way you're supposed to be. And it's not. You understand? So the main thing that I told everybody when we baptized them, because there were wolves around us in the baptism, because in the church, right, us as the pastors, God called us, right? Listen to this. God called us with a plan. He called us with a purpose. In the beginning, we didn't get it because we were so young and we were being led by other pastors or other people, right, that were in leadership that had, they were set in their ways, right? But when you look at the people of Israel and you look at Moses and what Moses was doing, those people, those older people that were set in their ways, yes, they knew the word. Yes, they may have had a connection to God. Yes, they may have served God, but it wasn't the purpose for the younger generation to do everything exactly the way the older ones did. The younger ones have to be more lenient for this generation. The leaders and the pastors and the, you know, the people that God is going to call for this generation, He's going to call them to be a little bit more lenient, a little bit more understanding, a little bit more, you know, to walk around with a little bit more empathy in their hearts, right? Because the older generation, when they crossed over, they missed the big picture. They missed the grace. They missed the Holy Spirit. They missed the mark. They missed the move of what God is trying to do in this season and in this time. So when we look at the news and we see how, you know, Satan has his foothold everywhere. He got his foothold in the school systems. You got parents who never wanted to homeschool because of COVID, now homeschooling and don't want their kids to go back to public school. Why? Because they see that the government has no control of their own system. Okay, what they created is a baby monsters everywhere. Why? Because they took God out of schools. They taking God out of hospitals. They taking God out of so many places in the world. So the generation that God is calling forth, right, to prepare the way for the king has to cross over from death to life. So when you look at this Bible verse and he says, whoever hears my word and believes, okay, in him and in the word and in the one who sent him, that person is going to have eternal life. So you're going to have eternal life for believing in Jesus and believing in the word. But guess what? God. That means that as you're crossing over, you're going to have to confront in your faith family members who have not crossed over. You crossed over. Your family hasn't crossed over. Your family may not want to cross over. The people in your home may not be ready to cross over. So your burden is going to be heavier because now you're battling against Satan. You're battling against the rulers of darkness. You're battling against principalities. You're battling against witches and warlocks and wolves and all type of unbelieving people, okay? And that are in the pulpit, that are in leadership. The people for this generation that God is rising up. You see, when God was revealing to me my purpose and my calling and what God was calling me to do, He had me understand that I am not those other pastors. I can't look like them. I can't dress like them. I can't talk like them. Even if I wanted to, or even if I could, it wasn't really who I was. So He said, I need you. Well, God bless you, Miss Gina. God bless you, sweetheart. You know, I need you to be honest, because the girls you're going to be dealing with, they drink liquor, they do drugs, they go to the strip club, they be out there prostituting. Like, these girls be having like 15 boyfriends, problems with their baby daddy, like, you know, dealing with side chicks. Like, you're going to deal with these other people. I need you to deal with. If you act like these other people, because you know what it's like to be there, you know what it's like to be in their shoes. You know what it's like to smoke and deal with addictions. You know what it's like to, you know, have, you know, a side chick trying to come through and trying to take over. Like, you know, you dealt with certain things in your life and you know what it is. So I need to bring you back to a place where you was comfortable, a place where you knew the language, you knew the waters. Okay. So when you testing the waters, as you cross over, you're going into new waters. Amen. So the life that you are living now, the life that you were living before, all of those things are playing a purpose into who God created you to be. So you can get certain things from Pastora Janice Batista, yes, and you can apply them to your life, but you got to stay true to the essence and who God created you to be as you're crossing over. You cannot allow somebody in your family, loved ones, friends, people at church to make you feel bad because you're crossing over the way God wanted you to cross over. Does that make sense to somebody? Can I get an amen? Can you guys share this video so other, you know, people can get on in here and hear this word? Because you have to cross over the way God wanted Isela to cross over. Isela has to be who God created her to be. Gina has to be who God created her to be. They both have a beautiful element that if they work with me, okay, and we move forward for the kingdom of God, and we push forward, right? We're gonna minister to the women who came from where we came from. Yes, there may be moments where God will put grace on you, right? And He will allow you to talk to people who not in the same, they don't have the same vibe, they don't have the same upbringing, they don't have the same anything. But guess what? God will use you to minister to those people and have grace, even if they older than you. So when you look at that older generation that was in the Bible, amen, and you look at how they were so stuck in their ways, they were stuck in their arrogance, they were stuck in their attitude, they were stuck in their misery, they was just stuck. God wanted the younger generation to allow Him to lead them. And that is the beautiful thing that I thank God that where I'm at today is only because I let God lead me. I didn't let those other pastors lead me. If anything, I pushed away from them. I had to block many of them on my cell phone. I was like, you know what? And many people may have seen it like rebellion. Like, oh, you know what? Like, she thinks she, I don't know who this little young little girl thinks she is, right? Over here trying to act like she's more holier than me. I've been in ministry 50 years, right? Who knows? Oh, she don't know what she's doing. Oh, she's so inexperienced. experience. Many people, yes, they may have said that about me and my husband's ministry. Yes, they probably still say that about our ministry, but it doesn't matter what they say. It doesn't matter because their thoughts, right? I take it to the cross. Amen. Their thoughts, it doesn't overpower me and who God created me to be. I'm being true to what God said to me. And if there are certain people, as God is leading me, and as God starts to lead you, he's going to show you that there's certain people that got a problem with your growth. They got a problem with the way God is communicating to you. And you don't have to pay those broken dishes. You don't got to pay the price for God, right? Speaking to you. Like, I don't need you to tell me how to communicate with God. I got my own relationship with God. I can hear God. I can talk to God. I can feel when God says go left, go right, don't do this, don't do that, right? So some people, they may not get you. They may not get you because they want to guide you. You gotta let the Holy Spirit guide you. Remember, there were many older people in that older generation that they couldn't go into the promised land because what God, the way they knew the Father wasn't the way they, you see, the Father was preparing the way through Moses. He was preparing the way through Elijah, through all these different men and women of God, through David, through Solomon, through Samson. He was preparing the way through Ruth, through Esther. He was preparing the way for Jesus. These older people that were set in their ways, they can't get it. They can't understand it. They can't comprehend it. Amen, Risa. To God be all the glory. They couldn't get it. So we gotta let God be God. And in this generation, right, we're preparing the way for the King. It's our job to prepare this generation. And this is the generation of rebellious, unbelieving people that do not believe in the word of God. They do not believe that young people can do what it do. They cannot believe that young people are being led by the Holy Spirit. They cannot believe that you can have some jeans on, you can have some hoops, you can have some nails on and go win some souls for the kingdom of God. They don't believe it. They don't. And even though they seeing it happen right before them, they still with that unbelieving heart like, she's gonna lead them astray. How do you know that? Do you know my heart? Do you know, you know, what I had to go through? Do you know the price that it cost me to cross over the way God has had me cross over? People are not gonna know the price that you had to pay for this calling, for this walk. But you gotta trust, amen. You gotta trust God. You gotta trust that God called you for this time to win certain people that I cannot reach, to win certain people that your family hasn't been able to reach. God called you and he set you apart to do a new thing. So when he says, whoever hears my word and believes in it and who has sent me has eternal life will not be condemned. It says he has crossed over from death unto life. So you don't gotta be, if God himself didn't condemn you, if I don't condemn you, because I understand, even look, you want me to put you onto something? Y'all want to like go crazy or something? And I'm not gonna blow nobody's spot, right? But listen to this. When we had the baptism, right, there was one person that the Lord touched them like, yo, put your cigarettes aside. Another one did it but was like going crazy like, oh, I need a cigarette, right? I was like, you know what, hold up, I'ma ask this person to see if they got a cigarette for you. Would another pastor have done that? Absolutely, probably not, right? Would another pastor agreed with my decision to do that? Probably not. They would have been like, you is not called by God. You is Satan yourself. They would have probably said so many things. But because I know what it's like to be, you know, wanting nicotine so bad, because I know what it's like, you know, and God messes with everybody differently. I can't be like, yo, don't do that, or don't do this, or just go and start judging everybody. You gotta lead them, but understand the way God dealt with me and my cigarettes is not the way God is gonna deal with the other one. So when I went to go get the cigarette from the other one, I didn't even know that the Lord touched her heart and was like, gave the cigarettes to the pastor and was like, I'm not gonna smoke no more, right? But then you see how God, but even after that, even after the baptism, even after all of that stuff, I can't go and tell the person don't smoke. If anything, when they had to go to the gas station. I was like, listen, you know what? I'll bring you to the gas station because I know I'm not the one doing the work. I'm not here to condemn them. You believe in Jesus Christ, you got eternal life. Now, the sins that you're battling with, the addictions that you're battling with, it's a day-to-day process where everybody got to day-to-day nail their sins to the cross. You got to every day nail your addictions. Every day, nail your attitude. Every day, nail your desires. Every single day, you got to say to God, God, good morning. God, excuse me, thank you for this beautiful day that you have given me. These are my struggles. This is what I'm going through. This is what I'm feeling. Because like I said, people who criticize me and judge me for my decisions or the way I may carry myself or the way if I have a glass of wine with a young lady, they may, you know, criticize me in so many different levels. But it doesn't, again, it doesn't matter. I know my salvation. They don't know me. They don't know what it costs. I know the fruit that I'm bearing. I know what I'm working towards. I know God has taught me in a supernatural way how to win people for his glory, how to restore families for his glory. So sometimes as you restoring people and as you helping people, God said you got to think like the serpent. What does the serpent do? The serpent is thinking like this, this, and that. You got to get on the serpent's level. Many people are not willing to get on the serpent's level in order for the next person to cross over. You have to be at that person's side. That's what it's all about, discipling people. You can't just expect, oh, you know, let me tell you who Jesus is, and then after that, I'm just going to tell you what to do, and that's that, and you're just going to listen to me, and if you don't listen to me, you're going down to the pits of hell, because it doesn't work like that. The gospel, amen, that I know, it doesn't work that way. It is this gospel that I know. You think you know it all, and God will bring you right back down and tell you, no, boo-boo, this is not the way. This is the way. And he's always teaching me and putting me in a position where I feel like so little. But it humbles me in a humble way where it's like, God, wow, thank you so much. I didn't know that. I didn't see things that way. I didn't understand that. God, thank you so much. Because while the other man judged me and condemned me and done through me down the disposal, God, you literally are teaching me, you're guiding me, you're molding me, you're helping me, you're not letting me go, you know. And as you crossing over, those are the type of people that you need to surround yourself with in ministry. You invite them to your house and they just sitting there like they not willing to get their hands dirty, they not willing to help you out, they just there to criticize your food, criticize your family, criticize your house. That's why I said my circle now is small. I don't care. I'm not inviting everybody to my house. The way I see you, the way you are portray, is the way I'm gonna portray you. The fruits that you bear is what I'm gonna see, and I am going to do as the word of God says, and I'm gonna protect my heart because I crossed over. I'm thinking about eternal life. I'm thinking about winning souls for the kingdom of God. I'm thinking about prospering and advancing the kingdom and allowing God to use me, allowing God to use my imperfections. And I'm in these waters and I have so many other people who are unbelieving around me, okay, that are just sitting there waiting for me to sink, okay, waiting for me to go down, right, waiting for me to sink like Peter, okay, into the waters, and people who are not willing to tell you, walk out on faith, step out on those waters. In this generation, the older generation doesn't want to prepare the way for the younger generation to preach the gospel after them. That's what was the difference between Elijah and Elijah, right? Elijah and Elijah, right? That was the difference between the two of them. When you have somebody that's willing to prepare the way for the younger generation so that they can do the will of God. Why? Because the younger generation generation, there is so much that they need from that older generation. But guess what? All the tag an older pastor, share this on your video, because these older pastors, they need to see that. You're not going to win the younger generation. You're not going to help them be effective, and you're not going to be effective with God if you're not willing to bend a little bit to the Holy Spirit. Let the Holy Spirit, you know, you got to bend when you're dealing with sinners. You got to bend when you go into the hood, when you're dealing with certain people that have lived 20 years, 30 years, 40 years without knowing who God is and who is the gospel and who is Jesus. You're going to have to bend a little bit and be a mom and dad for them. Be an auntie, be an uncle, be a cousin, be a sister. You're going to have to do more than just present them with Jesus Christ, because presenting them with Jesus Christ and just wiping your hands like this is not sufficient. Is not enough. God bless you, Miss Patrice. God bless you, hermana. You know, it's not enough. So when we look at this word, I want you to see this. It says, when you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and your Redeemer, you cross over from death into life. It says you no longer live for yourself or value the things like you used to. Okay, it says you have a relationship with God and you put him first. So I had to learn when I crossed over. Pastor Johnny wasn't trying to cross over. Pastor Johnny didn't really care about the kids crossing over. He didn't care about salvation. He didn't know Jesus. He didn't know eternal life. He didn't know anything but what the old, when he came into Christ, when he started to see, you know, the older generation and how they behave themselves and the yoke, okay? The older generation wants to put yokes, Pharisees, okay? I could say Pharisees, rulers of darkness, wolves, okay, in the temple, people who are not living in grace in the Holy Spirit. This is why a lot of people, they have a problem with the grace. When you talk about grace, they call it a doctrine, because they like, oh, those people, they don't dress holy. Those people, they don't talk holy. Those people, you know, they just don't wash their hands. They not holy. They don't honor the Sabbath. They don't cover their heads. They don't, you know, they drink wine. And those people, right? But when you look at God's holy people, they drink wine every Friday. Every Sabbath, they get together with their families and they drink wine and they read the word and they wake up every Saturday morning. And guess what they do? They go to the temple of God and they honor him the way they know how, the way they've been doing it for years, right? Too much legalism, the way they've been doing it for centuries. So God, when you look at the book of Esther and you see how Esther was afraid to go before the king, you see how this woman of God had a fast before presenting herself even to the king, okay? When you look at her life and you see how she started to be bold and she had to go before God to be able to save the lives of many other people, she had to put her life on the line. And that's what the younger generation is willing to do. The younger generation, even though we be scared, okay, because the spiritual waters is a lot of things we don't understand, it's a lot of things we don't see, it's a lot of things we may not get, but because we're bold in the hood, God needs that boldness from the hood to be used, amen, in the spirit. The same boldness you got when somebody steps on your sneakers and you be like ready to chop their head off, or the way somebody looks at you wrong or does something and you just ready to snap at them and just tell them what time it is, God needs that boldness to be repositioned. He needs that boldness to still exist, because it's what makes you who you are. But he needs it for the kingdom of God, so he can mold it, so he can use it, so you can be that bold, but against the principalities, against the rulers of darkness, so that you can see what the word says, that greater is he that is in you, right, than he that is in the world. It may look like the one that's in the world is bigger than you. It may look like the principalities and the rulers of darkness are bigger than you, but the one that is in you, right? What does the Bible say again? You believe in his word? you believe in the one who the Father sent, who is Jesus, you have eternal life. You will not be condemned because he has crossed you over from death unto life. So if he's not condemning you, why are you condemning you? God created you to be you. And there are certain things, yes, that God is going to put in alignment. Your attitude, the way he's going to show you a more mature way to carry yourself. He's going to show you a different way to move, a different way to talk. Yes, all of those things, you know, but he's also going to give you that heart of Timothy, where you're going to have to learn how to sometimes talk like you in the hood when you in the hood. You're going to have to learn how to talk to some white folks when you're around white folks. You're going to have to learn how to talk to black people in a certain way. Wherever God brings you around, Indian people, Jamaican people, African people, people in Nigeria, wherever it is, because we in it to win souls for the kingdom of God. So we all one. God doesn't look at color. God is not looking at, oh, this, and this, and that. Everybody has customs. Everybody has traditions from their grandmothers and things that their ancestors believed in. Jesus Christ came to go away with all of that. Now it's you. Now you need to live in reality. Like, now you believe in the word. Now you need to establish things for your generations. You gotta establish things for your kids. You gotta establish a legacy, and you gotta prepare the way in the city of Greensboro, in the city of wherever you at, in Florida, in New York, in California, wherever you at. God is gonna call you, okay, to set the fire, okay? Okay, set the gas, okay? He's going to call you to set the explosives in your city so that the kingdom of God can become alive, not only in you, but in those that are around you, because once they believe, they save. Now they just need to be discipled. Now they just need to be taught. Now they just need to be loved on. But there goes the wolves, always watching. The people who crossed over, there goes the wolves, always trying to tell them what to do. There goes the wolves, always pointing fingers. There they go, always bringing that unbelieving spirit in our circle. There they go. And that's why the waters, when you cross over, they need to be set. You need to know the temperatures of the water, because that's what God wants for you guys today. He wants you to know the temperatures of your waters, where you guys are walking through, right? So that you can value the relationship that you have with him, because you put him first. It says you enjoy giving and helping others with their problems. You enjoy that. That is what God called you to do. Amen. And if not, some of you enjoy when others help you with your problems and with your issues, right? But that's only for a season, because you got to learn. God is going to let people give to you, but it's so that you can give back. Okay. He says you accept hardships and suffering as a means of glorifying God and sharing in the sufferings of Christ. So yes, I share in the sufferings of Christ. Amen. Yes, receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. I share in the sufferings of Christ. What is the suffering of Christ? That I gotta be young in this generation. I gotta be bold. I gotta be, you know, myself, and I gotta deal with the criticisms. I gotta deal with the, you know, the attitudes. I gotta deal with the people that think they know it all. I gotta deal with so many people that, you know, don't like you, won't even give your ministry the time of day. You gotta deal with so many different things. You gotta deal with unbelieving family members rejecting you, pushing you aside, being fake, being phony, people who don't want to be associated. You know why? Because you're willing. I realize that, yo, I'm willing to pay the price that they're not willing to pay. And that's the reality. Because I love God and I crossed over, right? A lot of people, you're going to see that they're always like this. They're not ready to jump. They're not ready to jump off the cliff and just trust the Holy Spirit. When you jump off the cliff, you want the victory. You want the power of God to overflow in your life. You want God to use you. You want God to take you to new levels. You got to look a wolf in his face and be like, I know you. You see, I go into churches, God don't need me, but I look at the wolves and I'm on a different level. Now I'm protecting the sheep from the wolf. And now I let people know in their face, that's a wolf. And the wolf, I don't got to tell them what I'm doing, but I'm letting everybody know, yo, that's a wolf right there. Be careful with that one. Be careful with the fruit that they bearing. Be careful with their wickedness. Be careful with the things that they got going on. And just, I don't even care about the wolf, because all he could do is howl. All they can do is just, you know, try to act like they're gonna bite me, but you know what? They're not gonna bite me. They could send cats to my dreams. They could send thousands of animals to try to bite me in my dream because they can't bite me in the physical realm. And I know that I'm covered by God. I know that I'm protected by God. And I am more focused on protecting the flock and protecting God's house, protecting God's anointed, God's children, because I'm focused on them growing. I'm focused on them going to the next level. I'm focused on training them about darkness and how to power pray and do all of these things. But right now, in the basics, they're like infants. You got to care for them in such a way that, you know, you catering to them, you catering to their needs, you asking the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, lead me. What is it that they need? What is it that they desire? What is it that they need in their life right now, right? So he says, you enjoy giving and helping others with their problems, and you accept the hardships and the sufferings as a means of glorifying God and sharing in his sufferings in Christ. It says, but your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, and you find joy in doing what God expects of you. Amen. It says the burning hope of every Christian disciple must be crossing over from death unto life. So we got to ask the Lord God, if it's your will for me to cross over from death unto life, if this is your will and you just want me to believe in you and you just want me to believe in your word, then God, help me to not be so hard on myself and separate me from those people that are making it harder for me in my crossing over journey into this new life. You need to be you need to cut your circle. You need to cut it. The Lord is telling me, y'all need to take the scissors and start trimming some people. I don't care if they leaders. I don't care if they family members. I don't care. Your own family will do you wrong. Your own family will discourage you. Your own family will bury you in the grave. You hear me? They will bury you in the grave without your salvation just because they don't believe. Just because they didn't want to get in position and in alignment with what Jesus Christ was doing, because they didn't want to go to church, because they didn't want to submit to the God, the God that we serve, the Father, because they didn't want to submit and they didn't want to yield to his laws and his ways and his statutes, they so quick to see you struggle, right? They, right, Rosita? They so quick to see you go, they would love for you to die without your salvation. They would love to know that you died in fornication. They would love to know that you died in sin, that you don't go to church. They would love it. Why? Because their ways are wicked. Even though they in church, they blind as hell, okay? They cannot see, amen? They blind. They think they can see, but they cannot see, because they think they crossed over, but they drowned in the Nile River. They didn't cross over like Moses. You see, Moses, God, they haters. Yes, they had Moses. God had a plan for him. Other babies died in that river. God was like, Moses, I got a plan for you. You ain't gonna die in these waters, okay? You're not gonna die the way everybody else died in these rivers. There's a plan. There's a purpose. So in that plan, you may feel like Moses, where you like, dag, with my family, I'm too Christian. With the world, I'm too Christian. With my family, I'm too worldly. With the world, I'm too Christian. Like, you're gonna feel like you just never fit in anywhere, but it's okay. That's why God created this ministry, Destroying Evil Altars. It's for a bunch of women who don't fit in anywhere like me, because I feel sometimes like I'm too, you know, I'm too hood, too worldly for the older generation pastors, and sometimes for the younger generation I feel like I may be too holy over there or something like that. I don't know, but there's always areas in our life where we feel like we may not fit in that area, but as long as we're seeing the fruit of God's work, as long as we're seeing people coming into a realization that they need Christ and that the world ain't gonna get any better and that things are not gonna, you know, that things may look better, but look at the economy, look at the school system, look at the hospitals, there is so much harvest all over the world. God is just needing people to cross over in a mighty way, in a powerful way, so that they can move mountains. mountains. That's why God says, if you got a little bit of faith, you could tell that mountain to move. Why? Because you're seeing the bigger picture. You're seeing that the God that you serve is going to be the one that is going to do the work. It's not you. It's not me. It's him. So we just got to walk out on faith, okay, amongst these wolves. Faith is something that has to grow and grow and grow. But you see how this month, and I'm going to upload the word from yesterday. It was so powerful. It was called the power of weakness. The power of weakness. Because I felt like this whole month, we were talking about explosive power. I'm like, God, I couldn't even get on my Friday video. I've been in the ER where my daughter has been spiritual attacks. My AC upstairs broke after the before the baptism and after the baptism. Man, the devil has just been on the loose, okay? Trying to, like, you know, attack and attack and attack. But you know what? God still gets the glory. We still gonna worship him. We still gonna push forward for the kingdom of God because we recognize what we're doing. We are the devil. When you see these attacks coming into your life, rejoice in them because you know that you done pissed the devil off. You know that there's families that are being reconciled, and the devil thought that he was gonna have his way and that boo boo kitty was gonna take that family, and there is a new thing that God is doing. There is people that the enemy thought, like, I'm gonna keep that person bounded on the addiction, and the devil was like, and God is like, honey, that is not happening. I got my sheep, I got my warriors in the earth, and they are making it do what they do because they're not listening to the older generation, not because they're rebellious, but because if the older generation ain't willing to heed and trust that God is working in the younger generation in the way that he is, then guess what? Then they're not the ones that God is going to call me to walk into the promised land with. But I know that the older generation that God is, because I see it. Even the older generation, because I'm seeing one or two or three, four people that I see that we all walking in the same Holy Spirit and the same power of God. I see even that older generation that is willing to be flexible a little bit to what God is doing. Even they are under fire. They are under so much resistance by so many other older pastors and their associations in their city. God is making a division. The wolves over here and the sheep over here. And the wolves, or even some of them that may not be wolves, they just sheep that are so stuck in religiousness and so stuck in traditions and so stuck in their ways, even they are gonna be amazed and be like, I don't understand how God is using these little knuckleheads to fulfill the glory of God. I don't understand why these little knuckleheads, their churches is always growing. I don't understand how they bringing people right to the kingdom of God and how they're nurturing them and how are they caring for them. Like, I'm older. I'm the one that got the calling. I'm the one that knows more word. I'm the one that's this. And I'm why the arrogance. God cannot move. Or he cannot work with the arrogance. And when you truly got the Holy Spirit, that's why the word says too much word kills, because knowing too much word without the Spirit is not going to edify you. Yes, the word is power. Without the word, we got no power. But if you know God and you know the Holy Spirit and you have communion with the Holy Spirit, he's the one who makes the word come to life, because he knows when you're working in your own strength and when you're working letting him lead you, and when you letting, you know, the Holy Spirit guide you. That's what God is looking for, people to cross over and that are willing to cross over with him without fear, without any hesitation. And I pray in the mighty name of Jesus that if anybody is bothering you guys this morning, and anybody is making you guys feel less than, or anybody is not helping you and not pushing you, and they making y'all feel more frustrated and stagnant and just, you know, not feeling good in your walk, I just rebuke all of that now in the mighty name of Jesus. And I just declare the love of God over your life, the power, the boldness over your life that you need so that you can move forward, so that you can grow, and so that you can do things for the kingdom of God and help other people who are going to be crossing over in their journey, and so that you can lead the way for them the same way God is calling me to lead the way for you. Amen. Hallelujah. So I love you guys. I bless you guys. Please don't forget to share this video. Don't forget to like it. Amen. Don't forget to leave, drop your comments. Let me know how you feel with this situation, how you feel about the older generation, how you guys feel, you know, just in general with your walk, with your purpose, with what God is doing. You know, let me know in the mighty name of Jesus so that I can pray with you. We can connect together. I want to do some lives with some of the other girls. If you're interested, definitely hit me up so that we can, you know, have that girl chat. We can do that little table talk on the Kingdom Radio Show, and we can just talk and help other women grow, help other women. God bless you, Josie. Help other women, you know, and other men of God as well that be connected to this ministry so that they can grow, so that they can learn, and so that they can reach their true potential for this season, for their age, and for what God is doing with them. Amen. So I love you guys. I bless you guys. Have an awesome time. And don't remember, if you're in the city of Greensboro, I'm going to be doing Bible studies through the School of Fire on Thursday nights at the church. So it's going to be like courses, Bible study courses, where we're going to teach you guys how to connect with God. But I'm trying to get a group at the church that's only English. So if you're in the city of Greensboro and you are interested, the courses will be up soon online. As soon as we get that rolling, I think now on the website, I only have like 4 or 5 courses in English, I think, if I'm not mistaken. But anywho, more is coming. But if you're in the city of Greensboro and you're looking for a bilingual church, definitely come check us out. 2101 East Market Street, Greensboro, North Carolina. We have services every Sunday, bilingual services every Sunday at 11. We have childcare. We also have Wednesday nights at 7:00 p.m., which is the School of Fire. That is also free in the church. But if you come, if you get it online, you got to pay for it. So it's free. Those courses are free for those that are in the city and that take advantage of it. But the new and Monday nights, if your husband speaks Spanish, the men are getting together and praying on Monday nights as well at 7, men only in the building. And then on Thursday nights, like I said, soon, hopefully I will be doing the services myself there in English for all of the English speaking community that just wants the studies the same way I do it online. If they want it and they consistent with it on Thursdays, we'll definitely keep it going on Thursday nights and just let the Lord do what he does. But until then, we're gonna keep moving forward with the radio, English, Spanish. It's gonna be a lot of new things, fun things. And like I said, today's Motivational Monday, and I really pray that this word today was motivation for you, and that you just look at Mondays differently now with this Motivation Monday that we got going on, and just, you know, exalt the Lord and just let the Lord do great and mighty things in your life. Amen. So thank you guys so much for loving our ministry, praying for our ministry, always sowing into our ministry. Thank you so much for always sharing the videos and always staying connected and showing that love. I appreciate it so much. And I know that so much more is going to come in the mighty name of Jesus. Bendiciones.